So when we get to the boat, we can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do. What's hiding behind there?
No earthly key nor physical force can get past the magic of that lock. Don't even look at it.
Never seen a lock like that before.
Reminds me of something I've seen Tyr sketch. He liked to combine various symbols into runes all his own. This one, I believe, means...
peace, unity, mercy. Other things, too. I see what he did, but how do we get inside?
We have other concerns. To the chisel.
Boat under the bridge, keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Ymir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars for the Aesir were easily won, but the Vanir had proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. Both sides suffered tremendous losses, and for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore, but a rather senseless waste of precious life. Wouldn't you agree, brother? Precisely. Enough was enough. And at last, Odin's most brilliant advisor became determined to find a more enlightened path. He set about to broker a peace between the gods. It took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess, legendary not only for her fertile beauty, but her genius at the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Freya married Odin?
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand. I'll finish later, lad.
Ah, I can read what this says now, but it's a name. Whoa! The name made it light up!
It's the name of one of the Valkyries. That's quite curious.
Watch out! One more for the collection.
Mimir, you were in the middle of a story before. How would Freya agree to marry Odin?
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot.
Completely understand. I'll finish later, lad. I wonder what became of him.
Fafnir? What? Fafnir storeroom, Fafnir?
The very one.
But Sindri said he was a dwarf.
He was. And now he's a dragon. Funny how life works, isn't it?
He's chained up.
Perhaps we should keep an eye out for binding shrines and free the poor bastard. Aye, lads?
Go!
friend become a dragon, Amir?
Oh, he's no friend of mine. This little scroat was a constant source of annoyance amongst Aesir and Vanir alike.
Then why free him?
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like this. Even a greedy little dwarf come dragon.
Go!
remember you?
I don't know, lad. What's changed since we last crossed paths? I had legs.
This is good to know. Mimir, you were in the middle of a story before. How would Freya agree to marry Odin? What was in it for her?
It was a sacrifice to protect her people. A selfless act of love. Truly, she deserves better than she got. But of course, there's more to that story.
Ulfric. You were taken from this realm too early.
You who walks among the living, my beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace, yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones? Gross.
Gulvig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've lost.
Really? How?
Boy,
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death, if only for a short while.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of Sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Chisel is ahead, past this gate.
Father, maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out
Look if you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand.
I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. For instance, Odin hates the giants and they him. But Thor's own mother was the giantess Björgun, One of Odin's great loves.
So Thor's half-god and half-giant? Weird.
Once Fjorgun was gone, lonely ages passed for Odin. And as war with the Vanir raged, I could see what he really wanted beneath his bluster. And we'll pick this up later.
These bones pulse with magic.
It must be Gulvi. Could we just hold on to it? Maybe we'll find the rest of them.
This spirit lies to you, boy.
How would you know?
I have known many spirits. They are all liars.
This one is different. I know it.
You know very little.
So you were saying Odin was lonely? That's why he was always at war?
Nothing quite so simple. But I hoped that love might temper him and give us a chance for peace. And after no small amount of convincing, Freya agreed. For a while there, he really turned on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy. He granted her so many wishes, I can scarcely recall them all. The peace held, and I truly believed all had worked out better than I could have planned. But Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. He won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice she would live to bitterly regret. Sadly, despite his wise counselor's best efforts to persuade him that peace was the only true path to stave off Ragnarok, Odin never let go of his obsession with Jotunheim. The taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation and new levels of depravity.
Do you think that Fafnir went to Alfheim too?
I do not know.
Aren't you curious? He sounds interesting.
We go to the storeroom to collect anything useful for our journey, not to learn more about the dwarf.
Fafnir was a rather interesting fellow, little brother. Perhaps I'll tell you a story one day.
Hey, Sindri, could you take a look at this?
Honestly?
The travelers. Oh, disgusting. Smelly, covered in God knows how many little beasties, but gorgeous armor. Let's see if I can't make something more sanitary. Yes?
Yes, come in.
Where to next?
the deal.
Sure is a lot to see here.
Well, when you do need something, I'll be around. You made it out of Fafnir's storeroom yet? Let's get to it. How about you, young one?
I think you'll be pleased, young man.
Something else for you, then? Now, there is something else to tell you.
Trusting a spirit to keep its word is foolish, boy.
But if there's even a chance, don't you want to see Mom again?
Of course I... She is gone, Atreus. You must accept this.
I do, but to see her again, just one more time.
Why do you believe him? You do not know him or who he was. All of this is sinister.
He wants to see someone he loved again. I understand how that feels. I don't think there's anything sinister about it.
Hope is blinding your instincts, boy.
You want a beach here? That's an interesting gate.
I wonder who built it. Okay. Obviously, the marriage to Odin didn't last. But how did Frey end up a hermit in the woods?
Oh, that was a singular piece of cruelty, even for Odin. As if the marriage wasn't punishment enough. Freya was better to him than he deserved. She stuck it out through all manner of indignity, all in the name of maintaining peace and safety for her people.
You know what?
I'll tell this one later.
Boy, over here.
Sir. Hey, it's another treasure map. Hey, it's a fragment of a language cipher. We should look for more like this. Gulvig's bones.
What will you say to her?
To Gulvig?
Your mother. What have you left unsaid?
I just want to know if she's okay.
She is dead, boy.
I know that. You don't understand.
Neither do you.
Come on! What would you say to me?
Nothing.
Nothing?
There is nothing left to say.
What about everything we've done so far? That man coming to the house? Talking to the world serpent? We've done so many amazing things. I just want to tell her about them. Don't you?
What else would you say to her?
I tell her that we're both okay. Not to worry about us.
Atreus, I miss her too. You know this.
I thought I knew very little. Come here. You were telling us how Frey ended up living in the woods.
Aye, she married Odin. But Odin's madness, his tyranny, his corruption of her magics, it became more than she could stomach, and at long last she broke it off. Well, I can just tell you this story later.
Get to how Frey ended up living in the woods.
She'd finally reached her limit with Odin and broke things off. Odin's wrathless fierceness curses upon her one more than she dared to fear.
But your magic was so much stronger than his.
After so much time together, he knew her vulnerabilities and exploited them to craft curses she could never break.
Oh, that's not being able to leave Midgard.
You know what? I'll tell this one later.
We're not getting in there without a key. Okay, so Freya left, and Odin was mad.
Furious! And he cursed her most terribly. Worse still, he robbed her of a warrior spirit. Freya cannot fight, even to defend herself. No living thing may she harm by blade nor spell. In a world this belligerent, what choice does she have but isolation?
Poor Freya. I guess if I was her, I'd spit in your face too.
Aye, lad. So would I.
Are you okay?
No, son. My goods are underwater. My men are drowned, and yet their bodies continue to walk the beaches.
Hellwalkers. They plague these lands.
I was their captain. They died because of me. But these abominations sully their memories. I will find a way to free them from their tortured state. In this, I am determined. A thunderstorm scattered all three of my ships across the lake. I know not what I did to anger them.
Pretty weak.
Look here.
Yes, sir. Another map. Great.
final bone.
Yeah.
We might as well return them to the spirit. Maybe he will keep his word.
I know she's not coming back, okay? I know. I just... Never mind. I just gotta return the bones. Hey, look! A torch!
A torch is built with wood. That is a brazier.
A... brazier. Hmm. Looks like there's something written on it. Want me to read it? Hey, look! A torch!
A torch is built with wood. That is a brazier.
A... brazier. Hmm. Looks like there's something written on it. Want me to read it?
Father!
never seen one of those before. They look like they walk.
Well fought, you two.
You're dead?
You're very perceptive and reckless. Take caution when lighting these braziers. Sailor and Hellwalkers will swarm to the flames like moths. I assume we have you to thank for freeing us from a watery grave.
Us?
Other spirits. The Lake of Nine is full of them. Most are able to move on from this realm, but we, lucky few, are stuck here in Midgard until our affairs are in order. Perhaps you can help them as well.
We have no desire to help you, Spirit.
Ah, but you already have. I only wished to see the sky again. Farewell.
He disappeared.
Come, let us not be distracted.
A wolverine!
A dangerous beast. We will take him down together.
Watch your back!
Discovered opportunities for hunting and trade in these lands.
So, I guess we should keep an eye out for other spirits.
What did I say about distractions?
But it sounds like they needed help.
They are spirits, boy. Dead things. They have no needs, only wants.
It feels wrong to ignore them.
We will get over these feelings.
Mom would have wanted to help them.
What was that, boy?
Nothing.
I thought as much.
Amir, there was a shrine about a giant lady with lots of books and visions.
Ah, that would be Gloa, Knowledge Keeper. She was a gifted sorceress who gathered every tome of arcane wisdom she could find in the realms, all in the hopes of augmenting her powers of prophecy that she might find her lost husband. I'll tell you the story later.
Put that one, brother.
Yeah!
You have potential, boy. We have collected the rest of your woman's corpse spirit. Show us this magic you have promised.
Ah, my sweet Gulvig. Whole again. Rise, dear Gulvig. Awaken, O powerful Gulvig!
Erni Ukar Birthiast.
She says she'll honor our request.
Erdi Fagnar.
And reunite us?
In Gowder!
Okay, you're right.
What awful pain!
Boy.
This is true as well. But do not take your disappointment out on me, boy. Take it as a lesson.
Yes, sir.
This chisel we seek. What is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamur. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthor had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, the quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthor ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son, but in his emotional state soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And? What happened next?
You'll see.
Mimir, Thor killed him. Oh no. He fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamur fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. But truth is, the sweaty ball bag just got lucky.
Thank you. Silver!
A dangerous beast. We will take him down together.
Very giant.
That big circle on the giant's ring looks promising. Seem to do anything.
Oh, neat trick, lad.
Thanks. His idea.
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
Hey, wait for me! It's locked magically.
find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Hostiles. Do we fight them? Okay, here we go! I'm ready! An all-fine light crystal. Wonder what it's for. Sandy. How are we getting down there?
I have a plan.
You do?
Do not act so surprised.
Oh, no offense, brother. I don't even think Thor with Mjolnir in hand could get through that much ice.
Then Thor is a fool.
This should be entertaining.
Boy. Follow me, Atreus.
On my way!
Wow, that was something, that fight. Here, catch. Well, that was a waste of a perfectly good hour.
How were you not seen? There is nowhere here to hide.
Oh, that. It's a little trick my people can pull. A special way of not being seen.
You can be invisible?
More like I can step into the realm between realms. And your mind doesn't understand what it's seeing, so it sees nothing at all. That's how we avoid ever having to actually use the weapons we craft. It doesn't seem to work on dragons, though.
Your brother wanted to know if you're getting enough to eat. I guess I could tell him you are.
Brock was asking about me?
Was there meat on his breath?
You let him touch this again. Come on, then.
So that's how Brock was in the temple right after the water. He stepped between realms.
Okay, now shush. I need complete silence for this. There you go. So, what can I do for you two? Yes, dear boy? I know you'll use this wisely. Something else for you, then? Be seeing ya. What speaks to you? Happy to provide.
So, this plan of yours.
Can you guess it?
Knowing you, it doesn't involve standing around here.
Correct.
But how do we move forward? Boy, Farmer really liked jewelry, didn't he? Even braided his beard with it.
I happen to think he looks dashing. You know, for a snow-covered corpse.
Right here!
Hey, Sindri. We found something.
Armor piece? Oh, I hope it's a new armor piece.
So, this plan of yours.
Can you guess it?
Knowing you, it doesn't involve standing around here.
Correct.
But how do we move forward? We heading into that building?
Yes.
You think there's something inside that'll help us break the ice and get to the chisel tip?
No.
I'll keep thinking.
Arrows! Go! Right side!
I came here on a diplomatic mission once, trying to broker a peace between Asgard and Vanaheim. A war. So many lives lost. What I didn't know was Thor had already gone on a killing spree of giants.
What did the giants have to do with the war between the gods?
Nothing at all, lad. That's the tragedy of it. They took no side in that madness. But Odin's paranoia is surpassed only by Thor's lust for blood.
What now? Another crystal. Just give the word. most of it.
Well, a stealthy plan it is not.
Now we must free the other strap.
We do?
Yeah!
Why are we going up when what we need is all the way down there?
Think.
Well, the chisel tip is under thick layers of ice, so melting it won't work.
Correct.
And there weren't any shattered crystals nearby for me to shoot, so that's not an option.
Correct.
I just leave smashing the ice. We need something ridiculously heavy to... Oh, I get it now.
Good.
How are we going to turn the hammer so it lands near the chisel tip?
Not possible. We cut it free, write it down, and figure out what comes next after.
So your plan involves a whole bunch of luck, then?
You are welcome to suggest a different one.
What now?
Hold tight.
This plan seems ill-advised.
Quiet. Jump!
Excellent work. It only fell a little ways.
Oh no! The floor's collapsed. There's a sand bowl, but how do we get to it?
We cannot. What does it say?
When time itself is disarrayed, the forward path is retrograde. Retrograde? It's backwards?
Those symbols. The seasons?
Yeah, but the order's all jumbled. Shouldn't it be winter, spring, summer, autumn?
Why start with winter?
It's from a song Mother used to sing.
Don't I know that one? Winter that...
Quiet, Head.
Doesn't like music either. Got it!
Boy.
Var. House. Sumar. Sumar.
Nuh-uh. That wasn't right.
Do it.
Vetter. Var. Sumar. Sumar.
Still nothing.
Boy.
The order from the song again.
Winter, spring, summer, autumn.
There.
Vetter, Var, Sumar, House. It didn't work, but I know that's the order in the song Mom sang.
Boy.
Var, Sumar, Var, Vetter.
Retrograde, lads.
What?
Of course. The riddle. The answer is reversed. Do it.
Var. Sumar, Var, Vetter.
The riddle. Winter is last.
Here you go, brother.
Winter, spring, summer, autumn.
Boy.
House. Sumar, Var, Vetter.
Atreus, that word.
Thola. It means endure.
Try it.
Thola.
Well done, lad.
Write it again.
Thola. Horizon! The energy's lifting the platform.
Keep writing. Ed, how is this possible?
My guess? Temporal magic. Dangerous stuff the High Vanir gods used to play around with. The ability to freeze time. Happened to be a favorite of Njord himself, in fact.
Used to? Why did they stop?
Well, turns out stopping time keeps the sun and moon from streaking across the sky. Unfortunately, it does not stop the wolves that chase them, always looking to sink their teeth in. After that, they decided it was best to leave time alone.
I can't get to the wall! Watch out!
Writing before the floor collapses.
Thor.
Steady yourself, boy!
Thank you.
job! You did well.
Thanks.
The boy.
Just having a little fun, you big grump.
Well, there it is. How are we going to get it free?
A push.
But
trust me. Ready. Dig in and push with everything.
Yes, sir. How do we get down?
We jump.
Really?
Come. Do not panic.
Why would I panic?
I have you!
You're fried, you know that.
Well. Good. We should keep moving.
Credit. He has a talent for destroying things.
Remember that head.
Never leaves my mind.
Those were the guys we saw with Baldur. His nephews?
Aye. Magni and Modi. The sons of Thor.
Mother always said the Aesir were the worst of gods, and Thor was the worst of the Aesir. Guess he's a terrible father, too.
They are no longer children. They have no excuse.
Will Sindri be okay?
They'll never even see him. Ah, the great dining hall. Envy of all Midgard. Funny, I remember there being a massive candelabrum. Really livened up the place.
There.
Ah, yes.
You just can't help but break things, can you? Memory serves, the Jarl's throne was just on the other side of that wall of ice.
Behind you!
something ahead.
See, lad? He's fine.
Thought it best to vanish when Thor's idiot sons showed up.
Hey, Sindri. Check this out.
My, we're excited to spend some Hacksilver, aren't we?
I mean it. Focus and help me find it. Oh, God, this is poor father. Smack it, boy. No, I can't hope to disappoint father. Keep looking.
What speaks to you? Well.
Ah, offerings to Tyr. These are quite rare, you know.
Why?
Well, you know Odin, not the biggest fan of Tyr. I thought he destroyed all of these.
Where shall we begin?
That's a keeper.
I don't suppose you can try keeping that clean. Fine piece of work. If I say so myself. That'll come in handy. Also, remember to breathe. Well, that's something.
What else was there?
Poor Fafnir. There's a fine line between ambition and greed, you know. Sometimes the best purchase is the one we don't pay.
Hurry, brother. We may get a piece of the chisel and be gone before they even notice. Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Boy. Surrender. The old father demands it.
No.
Good. This fight is mine, boy. Go.
And where do you think you're going? Oh no, brother. The little freak's got a bow. What are we gonna do?
The shields are yours, brother. Don't tell me what to do, brother. I can't remember the last time we placed an extreme challenge. I'll take the rope. I'm a cripple, you! Unbelievable. You need to oppose my guys.
You've got so far, the kid. That was bad for you.
Stay behind me, boy. Why do you hunt us? What does Odin want?
No. Don't care. Come here, Hanyu-Reed. You're done with that hand.
Shut up! Don't call me that!
Can't believe you've lied, Mason. Skinny little arms can barely lift the bone.
I said shut up!
Calm yourself, boy.
Looks like they need another lesson.
More than happy to teach, brother. Daddy must be ashamed. I got a freak.
Mimir! I want that other arm. I'll get you. I bet Daddy's embarrassed to have to drag you around.
Shut it out. Focus.
Hang on, lad!
face of England on Earth.
Don't talk about my mother!
Don't talk about my mommy!
Don't listen to him, lad! He's trying to rile you up!
Idiot!
So
a sense of thought are welcome to try!
Head!
Sorry, overstepped, yeah?
Over here, freak!
I see them!
Tired!
Hello! We're
behind
coming
you.
For you!
Gonna
I
drag
see them.
Your carcass to us!
Try again, asshole!
There's a little run for it!
Stop it!
Boy, stay focused!
I'll take the little freak.
The boy's sick, he needs Freya.
No!
Steady.
I'll be all right.
There you go, lad.
I'm fine, see?
We should keep an eye on him.
Enough.
Should do. With that, we can carve the travel rune to Jotunheim. Get you where you need to go. Oh, incidentally, all those magically sealed doors we've seen can now be unlocked. Like that one round the corner. You can get through that door there now that you've got the chisel.